We've been asked by the outlying research farms to help with a controlled burn. We have about a 25-acre area of grass, and that prairie needs to be regenerated. And one of the most common aspects of regenerating a prairie is to use a controlled burn.
I'll be acting as the burn boss today, so I'll be directing the fire operation, how we light it and how we put it out and take care of it and watch where our smoke goes.
We'll probably try and cut it off around the east side of this pond and let the whole main body go. Then we'll come back and mess around with just firing out these smaller pieces.
Certain people will be lighting the fire using drip torches or other ignition devices called fusees. Other people will simply be working with hand tools to make sure the fire stays in the grass unit. And some other people will also be riding four-wheelers or ATVs that have some water just to monitor and put out the fire behind us as we go.
Landowners in Iowa are turning more and more towards using prescribed fire to control their grasslands or to regenerate their grasslands or their woodlands. And they really need to be careful when they burn. We're blessed with wind here in Iowa, and that can really be a double-edged sword. Nothing scares us more than putting smoke across a roadway where you could imperil lives, or put it into a livestock facility where you could harm those animals. And so really, we want to educate landowners how to use that wind in an appropriate manner. What steps need to be taken to have a safe and effective burn?
So that's the forecast. Devin, you want to update us on what we actually are seeing?
At 1320, I spun weather. We had 63 degrees air temperature and a 27% RH.
Most important things to watch for are the conditions that you're burning under, the weather conditions, what your wind is, what direction and speed, what your relative humidity is, because that will be most important in how quickly or slowly the fuel burns and how hot the fuel burns, the grass or the leaves that you're burning. Always have a prescribed burn plan that lays out who will be there, what weather conditions you'll burn under, and when you want to do it. At the time of the burn, make sure that those conditions are met, and then take your time, do it carefully. Always make sure you perhaps have a tractor or a four-wheeler there with some water available to help put out any spots that kind of slop out of your main fire.
If you're looking to burn, there are resources out there. ISU Extension has some publications that you can use and utilize. There are burn plans that can be downloaded from the web at ISU Extension. And if you feel uncomfortable, if you know you want to use fire but you feel uncomfortable about putting fire on the ground, there are resources and there are personnel out there with the training that can help you. And so ask. It's better to ask than have to call for help.
Visit with somebody who's done it before just to get an idea of the basics and how to develop some goals for your property. Visit with a local fire chief, your local DNR forester or something like that. Visit with an extension service person, the forestry extension service perhaps. Take care to look to watch your weather conditions and to know what the best time is to burn, what's the best time of year to achieve your goals with your fire and so forth.